everyone, welcome to Cosplayers React to Miraculous Ladybug. This time we're going to be reacting to Queen Banana, which is one that you guys requested.
I think I'm going to do the intro to this one. This is, of course, a Chloe episode. And this is, of course, Queen Banana. So I've come dressed for the occasion. What do you think, guys? What do you think of my fit?
You do look great. That's the thing, I can't even lie. You look great. You guys have been requesting the Queen Bee suit for ages, so
here it is,
guys. To do it for you. Yeah, this is what you meant, right?
I'm Hilda Glitz.
I'm Rascal Rabbit.
And I'm Luminara.
Let's go.
Let's go.
It's a cape. This one's for the suit.
Okay, not to start this off rinsing Marinette, right?
It's the character bleed, you're too Queen Banana.
The thing, I feel like the change of costume, Chloe's taking over my soul, but that is ugly, that garment, I hate it.
And this is Marinette, she's sewed everything she's wearing.
That's the thing, this is forgivable, what Chloe decides to wear, because Chloe clearly has no fashion sense, like, and I'll say that. But Marinette's supposed to be good at this. And yeah. This is what she's come up with, a poncho is what she's done.
This one's for the super villain of destruction.
I love the sort of the Disney princess energy of all of these little...
I thought that.
It's so cute.
Cinderella kind of birds.
But I also find it a bit cursed that, like, in their film, the superhero of destruction is the villain. And I'm like, so Cat Noir is nothing to you then?
Yeah, it continues.
He's overseeing this group of...
Thomas the Strip cameo, that was on our season 4 bingo.
Yes.
Everything's being done by the students themselves with financial support from Paris.
Alex making little swords.
Yeah. Oh, look at Kim with the light stand. That's what Jake was doing at the Patreon shoot.
I just love how they were getting a little bit of B-roll of Alex and she just turns around furious. Like, what you want.
As well as for the two young actresses who'll be starring in the main roles. You.
Right. Here we go. This is the first episode we've done with Ms. Zoe. Now, I feel like I want to set the record straight, okay? I did not give Zoe a chance when I was first watching this because I was like, Chloe's my girl. Who's this rando coming in, stealing her thunder? Don't like this. I really like Zoe, actually, so maybe I will add another bourgeois girl to my cosplay roster. We never know.
Giving the lead role to my half of a sister who just came out of nowhere and with daddy's money on top of it.
A little bit of fourth wall breaking there.
Don't let your sister walk all over you, Zoe.
Stay out of it, Marinette. This ain't your fight.
In fairness, Marinette butting in here. In this episode, it's not as bad as usual. I feel like she does have a leg to stand on here. She's not being as terrible as, I mean, she sucks. I hate her so much.
Milen's sweater is too ugly. Nate draws like a 2-year-old. Alia is useless and Marinette is ridiculous. Utterly ridiculous.
I said that?
Less politely.
Well, I still mean it.
I look how her first reason that was that Milen's sweater was too ugly. I'm like, mate. Jeez,
man.
Taking no prisoners.
It's also her being like, I said that.
That was me.
Am I the villain?
And here's the office of the producer, Bob Roth.
Surprise!
Girl boss moment.
Girl boss.
Chloe really is gaslight gatekeep girl boss, isn't she?
Not in the best interest of the film. Zoe is perfect for the role of the superhero of creation. The next plane for New York leaves in 30 minutes.
The savagery of Chloe looking up like Zoe's banishment in the background.
She's like, I'm gonna banish you. I'll book your flight.
I'll book your flight. Don't you worry about it.
Yeah.
You can have one checked bag. That's it.
Would you like to reserve a seat? Because you've got
do you want a window seat?
Yeah.
You can have a meal, you can have a little bottle of bubbly. Do you want it?
Are you vegetarian? Do you need the vegetarian meal?
I've been looking at her outfit, which is ridiculous, yet I love it.
It's good,
and
isn't it?
I feel like it's maybe meant to be a bit of a cross between Chloe and Marinette's outfits.
That's an interesting observation. I think you might be a bit right there.
I was looking at it for a minute and then I was like, hang on.
It does look a bit like a Marinette colour swap.
Yeah.
Also, speaking of character designs, you can kind of tell why Milen is going to be the mouse because look at her.
Oh, look at her. Oh, sweetie. She's very sweet.
I also shot a film in my youth. It was called Solitude.
Solitude is the film that Emily is in. You know, remember that?
Oh my God!
The sad film with her and the umbrella. That's Solitude.
I really enjoy Rose doing the makeup because it just makes me think of school plans.
Yeah!
It does! It's so cute! We were so right. We were.
Because most of the time you are a super disaster more than a superhero. Actually, I wasn't even thinking of Queen Bee.
Something I do want to say about, like, Chloe in season 4. She was very obviously, like, the mean girl. Everyone was scared of her. Like, she was just really, like, yes, she didn't really have any friends, but, like, everyone just was like, oh, better not mess with her. I feel like now, especially, like, post-Queen Bee Chloe, she's basically a bit of a laughing stock. Yeah. And she has embarrassed herself, like, quite severely in front of, like, the entirety of Paris by having her miraculous stripped of her. Like, I mean, that is... There's no coming back from that, is there? Yeah. Ladybug's like, nah. And Ladybug really do be handing these things out like they're candy. So to have her go, no, you're not having it anymore.
You get a miraculous.
Not you.
That's my favourite kind of bully redemption, to be fair. Like, they're still being actively mean, but because the main characters kind of stopped everybody from caring, it's just sort of like...
Yeah.
They're just like, oh, that's just Chloe. Just don't mind her.
Oh, here we go. Here's the fit.
Okay, let's discuss this Dolly Parton fantasy.
It's the cowboy hat with bananas stuck on. It's the cowboy boots, which I have to say, I mean, they are camp as hell, but...
They're very banana also. It's just so Hannah Montana, Disney Channel, celeb, like Hilary Duff kind of energy. I love it. Also, the existence of her having a Queen Bee suit outside of transforming into Queen Bee implies that, like the Ladybug suit, she had a Queen Bee suit made so she could pretend to be Queen Bee, even though she doesn't have the miraculous anymore.
It's very sad.
Fine, take three, action.
Where did they get this car from?
That is stunning.
Look at that.
I love that it looks like she's run everyone over.
Yeah. Oh my God, the absolute like Donkey Kong Mario Kart energy this has.
Except when she sees you all just lying around doing nothing, Queen Banana doesn't feel like saving you. She feels more like tossing you in the garbage.
Chloe, we're not changing everything again.
Hang on. Is the banana on her hat rhinestone?
Yes, it is. It's rhinestone. Oh, Adrian's going to jail.
Yeah, it's about time.
Entering
isn't it?
His jail
Getting
era.
Jail. His jail era.
Thanks, Adrian. It's really gorgeous of you. I mean, generous of you to come help us.
Happy to, Marinette. My father said it was for the good of the film.
Goodbye! Season 1, he's like, Adrian can't go to school because it's dangerous. Season 4, Adrian, just suspend him in a jail cell by helicopter, whatever.
The way I look at this, and the only word that comes to mind is specimen.
No, those are so lame. I want a giant yellow gorilla that throws exploding bananas.
She's been playing a little bit too much Donkey Kong, I think. And this time she's in the mood.
Tomorrow you'd better have this monkey business figured out.
We didn't even let Sabrina get in.
For God's sake.
Brutal.
Maybe the zoo will lend us an ape if we take extra good care of it.
You're not really gonna look...
Kim,
imagine
I love how...
going to the zoo and be like, excuse me, may I borrow one of your apes, please?
Kim is on the phone to the zoo
right now.
Right, I require your strongest ape.
Can it throw bananas?
And or explosives. Can we also paint him yellow?
Why isn't anyone here to shoot my big scene?
They shot everything last night. Right about now, they're probably over at the movie theater screening it.
Okay, that's not how that works. Right. I'm gonna get mad about this. Right, the filmmaker in me can't stand that. You can't shoot a film that evening and have it edited and ready for a cinema viewing overnight. You can't do that.
Have you considered that these editors are built different, though? They just woke up an hour early.
They just did it faster.
It's nightmare! Harmonic wind!
shot?
Where did they get a drone from?
It was Adrian in the cage.
Adrian.
Oh my god, he's dead.
Why is he modeling even in death?
Miss Keisha.
Miss Keisha.
Not Adrian holding Gabriel on the iPad so that he can watch the film. I mean, fair enough, at least Gabriel's watching the film, right? It's one person clapping.
It's Kim, he's like, yeah!
Yeah! Oh no, it's fine. Oh,
standing-o.
Standing-o.
Miss Dupain Cheng convinced me to watch this first scene. I found it very moving and Adrian is exceptional in it. I've therefore...
Why is that quite sweet? My son is so good at this movie.
I didn't really read it as sweet. I read it as him kind of being like, oh, obviously Adrian was the standout.
Yeah, yeah, but coming from his dad, who usually doesn't like spare him a single thought, yeah. You know, it's quite sweet to be like, I thought Adrian was very good in this movie.
Look at Nino. Nino's furious. Nino and Max just show up.
Decided to privately finance the movie based on the original screenplay.
Not Gabriel paying off Bob Roth!
But most of all, it's for the good of my plan. Chloe is always an excellent source of inspiration.
He's like, I've got my main Akuma girl back! Right. Yeah, dream team!
Two observations here, right? One, every day he akumatizes someone, right? This doesn't always involve, like, a full motion picture budget. That he's really.
That's the Akuma budget for the month blown.
The Akuma budget's gone. He's invested in this one. Like he wants. I mean, Chloe's not even that difficult to akumatize. Like it's happened so many times. But he's like, you know what? This is going to be a great Akuma. This is going to be a good one, right? I'm going to buy an entire movie. Like I'm going to commission a full motion picture just for this. And also the fact that like because the red like hang up thing was still there, it means that he didn't disconnect from the call. So Adrian's just like, what's that, Dad?
What's that, Dad? Yes! King!
That smile.
Damn smile.
Hey, wait! Adrian!
Oh, this is a good scene.
This is a good scene. I like this scene.
Actually, I came to suggest that you apologize to everyone.
Are you ill? They ruined my film!
Are you ill? Good for Adrian for standing up for her, though.
Yeah, literally. Like, I'm so proud of him for doing it. And even though, you know, we said this before, that his way of confronting someone is a bit poor. He's kind of like, actually, like, I was going to say, like, maybe you should apologize. And, like, you know, maybe you should be a better person or something, like, if you want to be. But, like, at least he's trying.
Yeah. Well, also, remember, he does know, you know, he knows Chloe super well, so also knows that she doesn't take kindly to this kind, like to any kind of criticism. So if he tries to make it sound like it's not criticism, she might listen.
Promise me you would make an effort to stop being mean to everyone, and I warned you that if you didn't, then we can no longer be friends.
I mean, good to have it, like, you know, he's got to set some boundaries, right? He's got to lay down the law. He's got to draw the line somewhere.
Oh, bless him though.
This it must be very hard.
He's so
for him
disappointed.
To do this.
It's the way. It's the way she thought that was like such a zinger, but Adrian's just still standing there, just like.
Like okay, cool.
Like clueless. He's just kind of like, oh, that didn't go as I expected. Oh well.
Oh, Chloe, you brought this on yourself. Like every single time, you are upset, but. Sad.
Do you reckon there are sort of like public health warnings in Paris where they're like, right, if you're feeling sad, right, if you're feeling any kind of extreme emotion, close windows and stuff, like make sure you like no butterflies.
Have a little Akuma pods
bunker.
To go and sit in.
Akuma bunker.
Do you think people use it as like a way to scam people where they're like, we don't know that this works, but we're going to claim that this is like an anti-Akuma spray and then people buy it.
Anti-Akuma spray.
So I give you the power to show them who the real star of Paris is.
Fine, but I want a giant monkey who throws exploding bananas.
She's really hung up on this monkey, isn't she? She's been playing a lot of Donkey Kong.
And of course is like, lady.
Lady, I'll make it happen. Oof. Right, this is a look. I don't know whether I like it.
I love it. I think it's great.
It's a bit much. I think the banana skirt I find a little unsettling. There's something about it. It's a bit
You know what? I feel like it would be less dangerous to everybody involved if they just gave her the Be Miraculous. Because she's been akumatized so many times now, she's just getting silly.
This is getting silly. Dude, like, and next time Mr. Pigeon gets akumatized, Captain Hawk can have a day off. Just get Queen Bee to come and do it, because it's easy, isn't it? And she'll feel like she's doing something, and Ladybug will be like, I could have done this on my own, it's fine.
Banana boom boom, action!
Banana boom boom. I mean,
don't write that.
This is name. Exactly what she wanted, right? Big, big monkey. Who throw wouldn't? A banana.
Monkey. Ooh. I genuinely thought she said kill them. Kill them.
Kill them. No, well, instead she's bananaed them.
That's worse, I think.
It's worse than being pigeoned.
What happens if, like, so...
What if somebody eats it?
Oh, God. That's a good... That's good, actually. If someone eats one of those bananas and Lucky Charm happens, they're then, like... vomit out the person. Like, what happens?
As a vegetarian, that's a very stressful.
So horrifying on so many levels.
Like, burst out of their chest.
Is it technically cannibalism if you eat a banana that was a person?
Well, it's not vegan for sure.
As a vegetarian, I am very stressed out at this point.
Right, so my question was going to be actually, so you know, was it the New York special when she didn't like Lucky Charm everything? So, like, all of Paris was, like, destroyed for a while before she... And then it didn't get fixed. Like, yeah. It didn't get magically fixed, so they had to rebuild it. So, if this happened and she couldn't do it, like, you know, she gets... This would be the time that Hawk Moth wins and nothing gets Lucky Charmed, right? What is the process then? How do you...
Are the bananas still technically alive?
Yeah, are you able to, like, locate your friends and family? Like... Of funerals, the
this
same
is
amount
horrifying.
Of money. This is what, can you like locate the bodies? I don't. I yeah.
Consider this banana bread.
You can't bake your friends
you
into banana bread.
Friends. Well, I guess if you're gonna cremate them.
But are they dead? Are they legally dead if you're a banana?
I guess like you can't really live, can you? Can you talk to them?
Can you have conscious thought? Oh my God, this is really a can of worms I did not want to open.
Well, let's just hope Ladybug fixes everything.
Gee,
right?
I hope so.
Hey there, Banana Queen. So what's your superpower? Making people slip on banana peels?
Well, no, it's turning people into bananas and ruining their life, Catnor. Can you please pay attention?
I love whenever he does a little cartoony lean on his, like, staff.
Yeah.
Like,
he's so cute.
Staff,
like,
love that boy.
Yeet. Ah!
He's so done. He's over that.
Oh, that was so cute. Oh my God, what the hell? That was so smooth as well. This
that.
Sent
That's
me.
So
this
funny.
Is so funny.
Zoe, ready for a transatlantic voyage on the Banana Express? Only if you promise to stop doing evil in Paris. Of course, I promise I'll be really good.
I really enjoyed that.
I promise I'll be good.
I'll
kill
be fine.
Someone. Uh-oh.
Oh.
Okay, what kind of... Now listen,
he's helping.
He was
you
helping.
Know.
The plan just went a little wrong. You know, mistakes happen. Things change.
Ladybug just like, this is unacceptable. We'll not be working with this man again.
0 out of 10. Ladybug after the fight, like, Canwha, can I have a word?
Oh, God.
Can I pull you aside from
him? Oh, no.
Can we just step outside?
You'll have to come out sometime, Ladybug. Especially if you don't want to see my monkey make a banana smoothie out of your kitty.
I was gonna say they have just abandoned Cat Noir. They just really yeah. were like, nah, he's made one mistake, he's nothing to us now.
Well, don't think about what he's done.
I feel like if I was Ladybug, I'd just expect him to be a banana now. I'd just expect him to be out of the picture, because that's kinda how
it rolls.
Also, does Chloe not realise how tube stations work? Like, she's like, oh, you have to come out sometime, and it's like, no, she could just leave out of various other exits now. There's no point camping at the front.
But Chloe's going to be
be furious.
I just love Queen Bee.
Yeah, she's got a point. This is so messy of Ladybug, right? She has the entire miraculous box at her disposal, and she goes, I'm gonna give you, Chloe's hated half-sister, her old miraculous.
And then Zoe's like, oh no, like genuinely, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm not comfortable with this. I don't want to be a superhero right now.
I don't want to take on the mantle of my half-sister's persona. Like, I don't want to do that. And Ladybug's like, nah, it's fine.
Nah, just do it. It'll be fine. Literally, don't even worry about it.
It'll be funny.
Stop it, Marinette, for God's sake.
Marinette, I'm begging you.
I can't do it. I'm not strong enough. I know you can do this.
I don't.
You have only
How do you know that information?
Pollen
buzz on. Oh, I love pollen so much. Look at pollen's
little
fur.
The little fluffy neck bit thing.
Oh, it's like, so cute.
I just like my cat's got that, and I just sometimes see her and I'm like, you are so beautiful.
Right, what do we think?
I'm absolutely obsessed with the braid.
The braid is great.
I love it.
It's the kind of like top heaviness of it, and the fact that if you're gonna do that, like at least make like the kind of the waist like a bit like artificially high. Don't put it there. I don't know.
I know it's supposed to be the slightly kind of like less like poised version of Queen Bee, right? Like it's a slightly more street version. I just don't like. I don't love this design. I know I'm biased, but I like Zoe.
Hey, you big eight! How about fighting someone your own size?
The plait is gorgeous. I'm obsessed with that.
Stunning. I'm obsessed with it.
What did she mean by that?
I don't know.
Someone your own size. Is she implying that she is?
She's going to grow.
Make my monster grow.
Oh, he's so angry.
He's so angry.
Queen Bee?
No. Oh, this my bit. Name's Vesperia.
Ding! So Vesperia, that's the name. Cat Noir's a bit smitten.
Yeah, no, this is a whole moment, isn't it?
Wow.
Ladybug's gonna need us again.
Thrilled to make your acquaintance, Vesperia.
It's the way he kisses her hand. Like, he kisses her hand. He's swooning a bit.
He's making his move.
Yeah, I was gonna say, bro, this is not the one.
I don't know, man. Ladybug, you gotta move in, mate.
Yeah, gotta move in. I kind of would be intrigued to see if they do a bit of a like Cat Noir loses interest in her, and then suddenly she's like, oh no, I never knew what I had until I didn't have it anymore.
Sweeter, more refined, and much nicer.
He's got a point. Plague's right.
I love how he's
always
commenting on this, though. It's like, Plague, you're a little rat boy. You've caused, like, apocalyptic events.
I was going to say, Plague, you and Chloe probably get on quite well.
You're not even capable of a fair fight with the new holder of the Bee Miraculous.
How dare you?
How dare you?
How dare you, Detective Diaz? I am your superior miraculous holder.
Oh no.
Well, she did say to Ladybug, she was like, I can't do this, I'm not strong enough. And Ladybug was like, no. Look what happened.
She got bananaed.
And so is Vesperia, don't you think, Cat Noir?
You counted your bananas
before
the... I
love Bug's new outfit. I know I've said it, but it just looks so good. Look at this smug little cat man.
They're both very smug, I like that.
No, not again!
She just gives up. She's like, oh, okay.
Oh, no, I'll try again another time. Don't worry about it. Got her. Ow! Bonk! Just whacked her over bonk. The head! Bonk! To be fair, though, Adrian probably was quite feeling like smacking Chloe over the head after that conversation they had.
Found it! I hate you, Ladybug, and you!
Wow.
The way she just pops up is brilliant.
That was a very 86th floor shot, I have to say. Oh, it's a little... She made Chloe a little bee one.
There is a way I could help you if you want. I don't want anything from you. You're non-existent to me. You're like...
Never mind then.
Queen Banana's film has turned out to be a flop.
A flop era. You funded it, mate. You're losing money on it.
Chloe, Your endless supply of anger promises multitudes of chaos.
He's really going in with another one, my god.
Hey, might as well.
We better recharge our Kwamis before Shadow Moth akumatizes her again.
Oh, he knows what's up. She's using that brain.
Asperia, m'lady.
Don't like that.
You may hate me, but I love you. And I always will, even if the whole world hates you.
It's the monologue from the film.
From the film. That Chloe wasn't involved in.
Yeah.
Way to add insult to injury because it's not even your words.
Oh, stop, it's a nice moment. Oh, there we go. I love that episode. I think that's a lot of fun. There are bits that like genuinely make me laugh a lot. I think it's got a nice little story. We will be continuing with our season 4 reactions very soon. So make sure that you are subscribed with the bell icon firmly on so that you don't miss any future videos. Thank you so much for watching. Let us know in the comments which episodes you would like to see us react to next. And we will see you next time. Bye!
Bye! Bye.
Oh, Pop-Off, get on. They're filming in 1080. What the heck? What's all that about?
I'm just checking out.
My ISO is set to the same.
4K.
24 frames per second, 1080. That's gonna look crunchy, mate.